Let's talk about this Google IT certification again. What up, everybody? This is your boy Tech G back with another video. And in this video, we are going to be talking about the Google IT certification. And this is in direct response to somebody who had a question about the certification. And this person actually made a video reply to me. And I think this video reply was done rather well. And it presented a lot of information that I think will be beneficial to those of you out there who are contemplating on taking this certification course or not. So let's get into it. All right. So a dude who goes by the name of Jay left this comment on that video. The original video was titled, "Is the Google IT Support Professional Certificate Worth It?" So Jay says, "So are you advising about this program without even taking it?" I responded by saying, yeah, my 18 years of working in IT allows for me to give advice on this subject. Jay then responded by saying, yet those 18 years of IT didn't allow you to figure out how much this course costs. FYI, if you simply clicked on the button, it would give you details. Each course costs $49 a month unless you purchase an annual membership of $400, which allows you to take unlimited courses. Otherwise, you'd pay the $49 per course per month. Personally, I feel the course is a letdown, too much information about too many things. On top of the reading material being links to wiki pages, I don't know how much weight Coursera certs hold, as the courses can all be BS for the most part. You can just Google test answers and find videos of the labs in order to pass. I passed it in a few days for free and have moved on to Python for everyone. I said, well, sounds like you should make a video. Well, guess what? Jay actually did make a video. Jay said, here's the link to the video, and I hope you are holding my beer. So let's go check out what Jay has to say. Now, be forewarned, Jay does have a bit of a potty mouth, but who cares? He does present some decent information in his video. Like I said earlier, I think some of you out there could possibly benefit from, as you were trying to figure out as to whether or not this course, the Google IT cert, is actually right for you. So let's go check out Jay. All right, here we are. So if you want to check out Jay's video, just do a YouTube search for Google IT Professional Certificate is Complete Garbage. That's the name of his video. Go check this dude out, sub to him, and all that great, wonderful stuff. So let's see what my man Jay got to say about this certificate.
All right, what's up? Making this video because I watched a guy's video, ITG, on the Google IT Support Professional Certificate and whether it's worth it to get it and all that. But I figured out the guy didn't even watch it, didn't even do it. Not watch it, but didn't even do it. And he kind of called me out saying, we'll make a video. And I hope you're holding my beer, man. Because here's that video.
Now, you're absolutely right, Jay. I did not take this course at all. And there's a reason why I didn't take this course. The reason is that I've been working in IT for 18 years. I already have a number of industry certifications, so there really is no need for me to take a course that is designed to introduce people to the wonderful world of IT. I've already been in this world for 18 years, so that's why I didn't take this course. My perspective was really just giving a bird's eye overview slash opinion about this entry-level course based off of my experience of working in IT, but more importantly, based off of my experience of actually teaching entry-level IT. When I was in the military, I was in the military for 13 years, and for about 4.5 of those years, I actually taught entry-level IT to a bunch of new recruits joining the Army. So I felt like my opinion was valid based off of 18 years of working in the industry and about 4 of those years actually teaching, to where I don't feel like I necessarily have to take a entry-level course to talk about something that I've already been doing for close to 2 decades now. So that's why I didn't take the course. But you did, so hopefully you got some great information for us. So let's check it out.
And I don't have any problem with you. I'm sure you're a cool dude. And I know that you know way more about IT than me, so I'm not, you know, trying to start a beef or anything. I'm just, you said make a video, so here we go.
And there is no beef. There is no beef. I'm not worried about beef. I just want to hear your perspective, because you actually went through the course. So that's why I asked you to make a video, because you actually went through it. So you are the quote unquote subject matter expert in terms of what this course actually has to offer, as opposed to somebody like me, because you went through it. So that's why I asked you to make a video, because I thought your experience could be valuable for others who are contemplating taking this course.
You're here. Not anyone's here because they are curious on if this Google certification is worthwhile getting, if it's going to advance your career, if it's going to get you a promotion, more money. And my answer is fuck no, fuck no, hell no, hell to the fuck no. And I'll tell you why. See, because you're under the impression that completing this course is going to allow you to say that you are an IT support professional certified through Google, which you will not be. You will have no affiliation with Google. You will have nothing. You will not receive anything from Google. Google does not offer a professional certificate in IT support. They do not. So you will not get anything from Google. What you will get is a professional certificate from Coursera. That is the website. Basically, the way that it works is they have hundreds and maybe thousands of different courses on there. It costs $50 a month per course. Okay, so if you sign up for, if you enrolled, basically subscribe to the course, each course is $50 per month. So if you sign up for 10 and a week later you didn't cancel any of them, you wouldn't be charged 50, you'd be charged 500, okay, per month until you complete or cancel. The other model is an annual subscription for $400, and you can just have complete access to everything on there. But it's pointless. It's pointless because your certificate, which does not come from Google, okay, has a disclaimer on it just telling you that it's not equivalent to anything that's real. Okay, Google does not offer an IT support professional certificate. Coursera offers the professional certificate. So you're asking the wrong question. You're asking if the Google cert, you know, the Google cert's worth it. You're not getting a Google cert. You're not getting any kind of certification. You are getting a fucking, basically, a participation trophy saying that you did it. I mean, the whole course is 100% bullshittable. You can do it in a couple hours. You don't need to do any of the fucking things. All you need to do is take the test and do the little labs. That's all you need to do. And you can look up the answers and find videos of people doing the labs and pass it in a fucking day and get that sweet, sweet fucking certificate. The final exam would show that you have the knowledge, because it's essay and it's basically answering, you know, in this office they need this networking set up and what would you recommend, that, you know, things that they use and troubleshoot, you know, all that kind of stuff. You would need to know the answers to that to pass the course. The problem is on Coursera, there's no wrong answer. There's no wrong answer. You can write "eat a dick" with exclamation point in fucking caps and get 100%. Okay? So I have it here. I'm not gonna take the time to record a video on my computer, on my video card and all that fucking shit. So I have it here, and what I'm gonna show you is right here. You see? Right there. Google IT support. Now, does this say professional certificate? Does that say anything after that? And my name's crossed out, obviously, and that was just a couple days ago, obviously, right there. Now, right here, here's our disclaimer. The online specialization named in the certificate may draw material on the course taught on campus. Like the watermark in the background, too? It's right here, just saying that it's right here. It's not equivalent to on campus. Now, this is just weird because, you know, if we go in here, we'll also see right here that it does not constitute enrollment. There's no university grade, course credit, or degree, and it doesn't even verify the identity of the user. Okay, so right here is what you're gonna get right there. My damn phone would, there you go. There's your professional certificate right there. That's your professional cert. See, Google licenses the Google IT support program, which consists of these five courses. And by completing these five courses, you will earn your Coursera professional certificate. Not the Google one, but Coursera. Okay? So, the reason that the disclaimer is a little weird is because there's university classes on there. I'm doing a Python class that's taught at University of Michigan. I mean, I'm actually going to stop doing that because I've put all these pieces together. Am I saying that this is absolute garbage? No, you can learn something. But what I'm saying is you are not going to receive anything from Google to advance your fucking career. could you possibly use this on your resume, saying that you have this fucking thing and maybe stand out and interview well and get a job? Yeah, maybe. It's not going to be a fucking $60,000, $70,000 job. You may get a minimum wage job at fucking Best Buy, at Geek Squad, but I honestly don't even think that you can get a job at that level. I still think that you're going to need like the A plus and security plus and all that. So, I mean, it's really up to you. I really feel bad if this is information coming to you halfway in, if you're paying for this. And you're like, what? I'm not being certified through Google. That's what this whole fucking thing is. And it's kind of gross that a company the size of Google would prey on people that are trying to better themselves and actually that don't have a degree. And it's all these people that have these high degrees and all this stuff being like dangling this fruit in front of everyone. Being like, yeah, here, just right here, it's right there. It's so easy to get. All you need to do is just do it. And then you get it and you find out that you get a disclaimer on it saying that it's... So that is the information that is not out there. Again, I cannot express this enough. You are not getting jack squat from Google. Anything. Zip, zilch. They license it to Coursera. Coursera says, sure thing, they passed this. It's possible that they put complete bullshit, but passed it. So hope that helps anyone that's trying to figure this shit out and do better for themselves. I'm sorry if I'm giving you bad news. And hit the like button, hit the dislike button, comment, don't comment. I really don't give a fuck. Later.
All right, so you heard it from my man Jay right there, who says the Google IT cert is a complete waste of time. You heard it straight from his mouth. Go support that man and his channel and all that great, wonderful stuff. Now, I actually do agree with some of the things that Jay did say in this video, and I appreciate him for making that response video, educating everybody out there about this course, being that he went through it and he's telling his perspective from a firsthand basis. Now, when it comes to the Google IT cert, if you honestly think that you're going to take this cert and then go out there and get an entry-level job in IT, I highly doubt that's going to happen. I mean, I just don't really see it happening. What I mean is, if you go to a website like Indeed or some other job posting site and you do a Google search for, not a Google search, but you do an Indeed search for the Google IT certification, I really just don't see a bunch of jobs popping up that are asking for that certification as a prerequisite to applying for the job. Now, what you will do, or what you will see, is if you do a search for entry-level IT jobs on Indeed or other job posting sites, you're oftentimes going to see a bunch of employers asking for either A+, Network+, Security+, or a combination of the three. I just highly doubt you're going to see Google IT certification being a prerequisite. Now, that's not to say that the course is ultimately bad, because if you do take the course, you probably are going to learn some things that are directly related to entry-level IT, and that stuff can help you in terms of getting some type of education and knowledge. And ultimately, you can probably use that stuff to apply towards actually getting a standard entry-level IT certification, like the ones I keep saying, IT Fundamentals, A+, Net+, Security+, and so on, right? So it's probably good in that aspect, but it's more than likely not good in the aspect of you thinking this is all you're going to need to go out there and land your first job in IT. So I just want to put that out there. Shout out to my man Jay for giving his perspective. Like I said, there is no beef, homie. You had some knowledge. I asked you to present that knowledge and you presented the knowledge. And I appreciate that, because that knowledge, I believe, will help somebody out there make a better informed decision as to whether or not they are going to, or not necessarily they're going to, but as to whether or not they're going to get some type of benefit from the Google IT Coursera certification. All right. So for the rest of you out there, if you felt like you've gotten something valuable from this video, please go ahead and hit the like button, the share button, drop a comment below. But most importantly, hit that subscribe button. Also, go visit my website, Technology G, so that you can get read up on the latest and greatest concerning entry-level certs and just basic stuff about IT in general. That's technologyg.com. And until next video, ladies and gentlemen, peace.